I'm actually terrible at it. But I thought it'd be fun, and I gotta be honest, we were driving through your town, drove through your square. Who came up with that idea? I didn't know whether it was my turn to go or somebody else's turn to go. God bless you, but that's ridiculous. Funny thing is, I'm from a small town myself. In fact, every single person in this band, we're from tiny towns that nobody's ever heard of. You guys don't know much about that, do you? The guy at the golf course said, "What are you doing here?" Well, that's where, we're playing tonight, man. They said, "Somebody booked us to come and play." Well, why in the world would they do that? I don't know. It's where the bus stopped. But I'm from a small town like that myself. And from a tiny little church. I'm talking about like a 35, 40 people church. And my grandfather, well, he was the music director, which basically means he waved his hands at people all the time. Half the time he was waving at the congregation, half the time he was waving at his first grandson. Tell him to sit down and shut up, boy. My mom is the oldest of five sisters. They can all sing better than me. And I grew up in a musical family, to say the least. Interesting thing, I was one of those kids that wouldn't sit still. Back then, I didn't know what to call it. I guess today they call it ADD or ADHD, I don't know. Back then, also, there was no medication except for a paddle. It worked. But I remember being the kid in the pews who was running around like crazy. I was always trying to find the grape juice so I could drink all of them with my friends. And I remember one particular Sunday we were in the pews, and I think I was just laid out on the pew, you know, squirming around, whatever. They were singing like the ninth stanza of "Just As I Am," you know? And my mom had tried everything she possibly could to get me to chill, right? Everything. And she grabbed me by the hand, she pulled me out of the seat, stood me up. I thought, here comes the paddle right now. But then she looked down at me and she said, "Son, do you have the harmony yet?" And something happened. I can't explain it. But immediately, I was totally all about music. And I just want to take a moment and say, you may think that your church is small and insignificant, but it is not. And you may think that those old songs that you sing sometimes are dated and they don't matter, but they are not. You see, the truth is that the small local church and the old songs are what laid the foundation for me and for these guys in this band to travel for the last 17 years around the world. I just want to make sure that you hear me say, man, invest in your church. Go to your church. Tithe to your church. Go out there and actually be the body of Christ. Because every single time that I've stood alone in my life and said I didn't need the church, I didn't need accountability, was the time that I found myself in a hole and messed up and broken. And yes, the church is flawed, but if you take a look at, by and large, the church has done amazing things and continues to do amazing things for the kingdom of God today. Lessons. She had a board. It was a red board. I'm not going to lie. And it said on the board, my mom wrote it on the board with dots on every corner of the letters, "Because we love you." What the heck does that mean? But my mom taught me many lessons, and the number one lesson she taught me was this. She said, "Jason, you can go anywhere you want in this life. Anything is possible. You serve a God who has power and dominion over all things on this earth. And if you are called to do it, I promise you, son, you can do anything you put your mind to." She said, "But you will never get to where you're going if you don't remember where you are from, son." And And so tonight, after touring for 17 years and putting away songs for the last 8 years, we decided that maybe what we should do is pull out some songs from the vault. From our first record, it was a green record, it was called The Space in Between Us. And we were on the Hits Deep tour with Toby Mac, and Colton came walking in our dressing room humming one of our songs. I was like, you know that? What are you talking about, man? I was in youth group, it was awesome. I said, all right, that's pretty cool. He said, why don't you play those songs anymore? I said, because I'm sick and tired of them. He said, if you will play them, I will sing them. And so we decided tonight we would play for you the first three songs that we ever sent to radio back in 2004. Starting with a song called Glory Defined. It goes a little bit like this.
Stress test, and you hold me wrong.
singing with him. He's too daggum good. Actually, I guess I kind of do. Every night he comes up and he sings a little bit. I'm like, oh my gosh, that guy's awesome. And it's an honor to know that Christian music is in his hands moving forward, right? How about that, huh? Introduce you to our band. From the great state of North Carolina, he is a resident surfer dude from the Outer Banks. So gifted, so talented, and such a great surfer. I really don't like it. On the drums, Mr. Michael Anderson, everybody! Come on! And that's my brother who has been with me for the last 17 years. I said, Michael Anderson, everybody, come on! Alright, this guy over here, I don't know, what do I say? Well, his mom is one of the five sisters that I talked about, alright? In other words, he's my first cousin. And he just got engaged 2 weeks ago. Happy day, I'm all friendly. Yes, thank God. Please make some noise for my cousin on the keys, Mr. AJ Gilmer, everybody. Come on. Alright, alright, alright. All the way from the great state of Kentucky, the fourth great grandson of Colton. On the bass guitar, Mr. Aaron Branch, everyone. This guy looks scary. I know what you're thinking. If you saw him in a dark alley, you would run the other way. So bad. But then you get to know him, you find out he's a sweetheart. By far the sweetest person in the band. Love this guy. Great demeanor. He's been my rock star guitar player for many, many years. Please make some noise for the best man in the band, Mr. Jesus Garcia. My name is Jason, and we are Building 429. We got a bunch of songs that we're going to play for you. In fact, most of the songs you know, you just don't know that you know them. That seems to be a